product which you don't need for this workshop, but one, I think, for me it's the most important part, it's the Quartz composer. So, if anyone wants to use it now? You have, okay. That's good. People prepare for the workshops.
Yeah,
okay. That's the main window and the viewer. And it is from the architecture, it's similar to node-based programming systems like maybe the mother was MaxMSP. Then there's a free version of this called Your Data. These softwares are on both systems available, on Mac OS X and Windows. And there's another node-based graphical programming system on Windows only. This is called VVVV 4444 from maybe I can also choose the settings. We forgot this for the one on this version. Then maybe another concept which is one really strong feature of Quartz Composer is that it actually it's not running on system power, it's running on the power of the graphic card. So it uses it for everything you do here in the interface is really good, it's OpenGL based, so you can do like 3D stuff with maybe you have, yeah, one. If you're working with 3D, maybe that's an additional patch you should get in, it's like the trackball object. That's good for working with the Quartz Composer itself. Environment, trackball, and with a trackball. So I did here something, some stuff, and okay, I move the trackball a little further. I do a duplicate of this one, and then I take these and do command X like cut, and go into the double click, I go into the object. So here's my track. Your trackball is like it hasn't rounded edges, it goes straight on the edges. It's a macro patch, which can contain different stuff. And if I do a command V for a copy and paste, I get my stuff like here. And everything is now resided into the object, but you can't see anything because I did the clear up and above. So I have to change here. I just click on one of the yellow numbers. It is okay, if which one? And if you select here the layer one, it was clear on the lowest level and the trackball object on the second level. And if you have the trackball object, you can, you should, can, I can't try it. Okay, I can't. Oh. Q. is my cube. Therefore, that the cube is a 3D object, and as a 3D object, it needs an extra renderer called environment. Extra environment, which is called lighting. So I take this with cut, double click this one, and do the paste. And now I got my cube in here, and therefore that's now a 3D object. I can, with a drag and drop with the mouse, I can rotate it. And with the lightning object, there's light on it. And so, next step would be we disappear here. I don't know if you need it, but it's not complicated. You put every macro patch, I put a clear. So here's my cube. I go up a level above where I have my lighting object. Maybe I need this afterwards. And there is my main trackball object. And the trackball object is just for you can move the object around and see what it looks like on the other side, maybe. And therefore, there's also this inspector window. Come on, E, where it is, where the inspector. Okay. I can do like the settings of the trackball object are very interesting because you can do here the auto rotation and you give the friction to none and it will rotate as the given speed you stop it and rotate, keep on rotating. So quite nice, we have a rotating cube. And the next step would be maybe tweaking the lighting a little bit with the input parameters. I can say, okay, I want to have the material a little bit more shiny. Which side is shiny? Not so much more to do, but okay, here it's more bright. You can also choose a different color for light, as you want to have maybe orange.